Yo, what's good? This is St. Joe, soundsofgear.com. Today I'm checking out the Akai Advance 61, in case you want to see the box. Here it is. So this is what the box would look like. And here's the front, tells you all the stuff you get with it and everything like that. So you may have seen me using it, you know, in different videos and reviews and stuff like that. I've been using it, just getting used to it, you know, seeing how the workflow is, the quirks and different things like that. And I've been getting questions on it, so I wanted to make sure to let you guys know what I think. So what I want to do is kind of go in. I'm not really going to spend too much time on the layout because I think most people are going to be familiar with this. If you're looking at this video, you probably already seen the layout and the pictures and different stuff like that. But mainly, I want to show you how the software works, how it integrates with third-party plugins and different stuff like that. So let's check it out. All right, so here's the Advance 61. Pretty familiar with the layout. I'm pretty sure you've seen it. Hardware-wise, you know, you got your controls over here for your mod and pitch. Octave up and down. You got your ARP settings here. Different navigation for the different modes. Browser control and all the different stuff. You can browse to your pages. Transport, tap tempo, note repeat. You got your banks for your pads. Your cursor, you know, your knob, selection knob, and then your controllers, buttons, and your pads over here. So I know a lot of people are really mainly interested in how it actually works, specifically with, you know, different types of plugins and stuff. So I want to show you the software and how that works. So you see right here, you got all your presets over here, the browser, and you can go through and look. You also can search. Right here, you see whatever presets, whatever plugins you have and how many presets there are. Then you see expansions. You can see some of my contact or my complete stuff in there. It works with that as well, and I'll show you how to do that. And then over here, you got your different tags. You can actually add your own tags, but you can't add expansions, which hopefully they change that, because if you're using, like, let's say you're using Massive and you have a bunch of third-party expansions that you want to tag, you can import, you know, those different presets, but they just show up in the main list. You can't actually give it an expansion name, so I wish they would do that. Also, you can go in here and look at the plugin, set list, and even the store. If you want to go in, you can see some of the stuff that comes free when you get this. So, and one thing for me, I noticed when I'm switching back and forth between some of this stuff, sometimes it will kind of freeze up or blank out on me. And I talked to them about it. Windows 10 isn't officially supported, so some of the quirks that I've seen may be due to Windows 10. But when that happens, I just close the plugin window and open it back up. I don't have to reload it or anything like that. I just find, especially like when I'm going between the store, maybe between the plugin and the browser. But anyway, so that's pretty straightforward. Down here, you got your controls. You can see a graphical representation of your knobs and your buttons, and go over here and see your keys. Then you got your multi-section, where you can just drag presets directly into each slot. You can adjust the levels, the panning, even the key, you know, the key ranges for each individual one. So really, really a straightforward setup. And let's just focus on how it works from the controller. So I'm in the main view right now. So I'm in hybrid. So that's what I see. I see all of my presets for hybrid, and I can go through and just pick them out. One thing I wish on the browser is you always have to pick doing this. Like, you always have to go and then press it. So I wish they would allow this to kind of, you know, go up and down when you're browsing through your presets. Anyway, let's go into the main browser. So here's the big browser where you see everything. And you can go over here to maybe plugins. So if I want to look at my plugins, I can do that. If I want to browse everything, let's say right now I'm focused on hybrid, but if I want to clear that, I can go right here where it says clear category. That's going to clear all my current selections, and now I can browse everything. So now I can go through and say maybe I just want to look at instruments. Now I can go through and find, like, maybe choir or brass, or let's do bass. So we can find any bass across all those plugins. I can just go through, let's see. Now again, if I want to see everything again, I can go here and just clear the category, and now I can just browse everything. Like, maybe we want to see some orchestra or maybe some pads. Go into pads, and now I'm browsing all my pads. If I want to see what the buttons or the knobs are actually controlling, I can just go to the control page. You can change your pages right here. If you press it again, it'll show you what is, you know, assigned to the buttons. Press it again, it'll show you the notes for the pads. And you can also MIDI map. So if I press shift and control, I get into the MIDI map mode where I got my four banks of pads, but I haven't found out a way to add multiple pages of buttons. So it seems like there's just, you know, eight buttons and eight knobs. If somebody else knows a different way to add more pages, please let me know, because I haven't been able to figure that out. Anyway, so you got that. Now you probably want to know, how do we set up a multi from the controllers? Actually, really straightforward. So we can just start with that. So we'll start with that. If I go up here, you see where it says sound one. If I go over, now I'm on sound two. Press it. Now I can add something there. So let's go in and I'm going to clear this category again. And let's add something orchestral to this pad. So I'll go orchestral and maybe let's see what this sounds like. That sounds good. Go into the multi, and now you have control over that stuff. I can go in, mute it. Solo. Of course, I got control over each one, so if I want to kind of make this lower. And one thing to remember, anytime you start layering something, it automatically creates a new multi for you. So now let's go back and maybe we want to add something else. We go to three, and this time I want to go, maybe we want to do like, maybe organ. Or no, let's try some type of piano. Let's see what we got in there. See what happens. Doesn't really sound like a piano. Got Vacuum Pro. There's Expand. So you can see, I mean, it's really quick to do that. And then you can actually clear things. So right now, you know, I'm just going through the different ones. And you can use your, you know, knob to switch them as well. If you press up again, clear slot, gets a rectangle around it. And now if I press it, it'll get rid of whatever's there. And now I can just focus back on this one right here. So now let's check out the third-party stuff. So it's really cool how they handle the plugins. When I just pointed to my plugin folder, it scanned everything. And anything that it had the maps already for, it automatically imported that stuff. So you only have to go in and manually import maps for things, especially like it seems like, you know, Contact or Reactor, where they use a lot of different, you know, expansions. You can go in and import stuff like that. Or if you want to manually import individual presets or, you know, user presets and stuff like that. But anyway, let's do a few different ones. We'll do Arturia, that. We'll do Absinthe. Let's find something else. Maybe we'll try, just pick a few out. We'll do a Contact so we can use some Contact stuff. Massive. We'll do the SEM. I'll just throw Omnisphere in there as well. Reactor, Sample Tank. So let's do those. So click OK. And you can see right here, you might be like, where's the presets for it? So when you're looking at your browser, anything that's bold, that means it matches your current selection. So if you want to clear everything, the same thing I showed you how to do down here where you clear the category or clear all, you can do right here. So this is going to clear everything. And now I'm just browsing all the stuff and you can see all the stuff is there. So let's go back to plugins and let's try, I guess we'll just start with Absinthe. So there's 2,000 of those. Again, if I want to go maybe to specific instruments, maybe in here I want something that is a pad. And now I can look at all the pads for Absinthe. And normally you would see the plugin down here. The reason you see this is because this is the icon for a multi. Because if you remember, we actually made a multi. So that's why this is showing. This shows you that you're working in a multi. But, you know, normally you would see like the little plugin, a representation of the plugin there. One thing that's really cool about the browser, like check this out. So let's say I have this. Mm-hmm. So if you notice what I just did, while I was holding the note for the current patch, and then I switched to a new one, the note still held and I could play the new patch. So now this one, since I let go, it's just that one. But let's say if we go here, so say we have this, then I'll find something else. That's something that I hadn't really seen a lot of people talk about, because that's not layering. That's just kind of like as you're switching, you can go through and pull stuff up. But anyway, so let's go back over here. You see, oh, let me show you that actually works. So you can see it actually can control that stuff. So you do get control over your third-party stuff. Let's go back to the browser. This time I'm going to clear all. And I want to go to, let's see, maybe we'll try do an ARP and just pull up something random for that. And I find that it works really fast in terms of loading your plugins. I mean, I do really wish we had some kind of scribble strip over here where you can actually see what you're controlling directly by the knob, but you get a nice representation on the screen. So again, you see it works with that. Let's try something else. Let's do, let's see, I'm gonna clear it all just in case. This time I'm going to go to, let's do an expansion. So if I go up here and go to expansions, I can see like damage and evolve or whatever. Monarch, let's try Monarch. And I want to go to a base. So I can go here and do base. And then I can just find whatever I want, like... So you get your control. I mean, it's all there. So it works with that. Let's clear that again. And this time I'm going to do something from, I'm just trying to show you a few different third-party plugins that it actually works with, just to show you that it, you know, the process of it. And you can see right here, I can actually go in and browse and load different multis. So you can save when you stack stuff, you can actually pull them back up. You can see all the multis. Anytime we make one, it just goes in there and calls it new multi. You can go in and rename it in the software. But anyway, so let's do here's sample tank. So we got sample tank, and I want to go maybe into, let's find something orchestral and sample tank. And now I can just go through and blow up like the orchestra. And depending on the plugin, like this one, it just says macros. So for this one, you may want to go and actually see what you're controlling, like pull up the plugin interface. But again, it really works. Let's try. It's pretty straightforward. Also, your ARP and everything works with, you know, all your third-party stuff. So let's find a lead of some sort. Let's do, this time I'm going to just browse everything. And we'll just go into leads. And now I can see all the leads for any of the plugins I have loaded. So, let's see. Do this. Now let's say I want to actually edit that. I can latch it. I So the ARPworks, and the really dope thing is the ARPworks with external gear as well. Like, I can use this with all of my external synths, no problem, because it's coming from the keyboard and not the software, so it doesn't take any crazy routing. I can just turn it on and actually play it. And honestly, I don't even have to have the software open. Like, when I'm using this just with my external gear, I can just turn on the ARP and it works. So I definitely like that. A few issues I've found is, like, with the transport, like the maps. Like, if I go here, if I go shift and set up, you see all these different DAW presets. I haven't found them to really actually work, you know, for me. Again, I don't know if that's because I'm dealing with Windows 10. So anybody else that has this, if you're using these, let me know if any of these templates work for you. I've tried Bitwig, Cubase, Ableton, Studio One. I even tried the MPC. The MPC one worked a little bit after I changed a few things, but I find that, you know, out of the box, these didn't really work just by going in and choosing the advance as the remote and different stuff like that. Now, of course, I can go in and map whatever I want to my transport inside of a DAW, but again, I would expect these to work, so I don't know if they're going to have to do an update for that or what. Me, I rarely actually use transports there, so it's not a big deal. But some of the things that definitely I want to see a little bit more stability with Windows 10 in terms of, like I said, sometimes I get this interface to kind of lock up on me. Let's see if it happened. So it didn't happen now, but sometimes when I'm switching through, going back and forth, like, it'll be a blank screen. I just close it and open it right back up, and it works. That, but the main thing, like this here, you know, not having any, not being able to add pages there, I definitely wish that they would get a handle on that. But overall, man, like, I'm honestly was impressed. I expected it to be a lot of crashes and different things. I'm not gonna lie to you. That's honestly what I was expecting, and I haven't really had any of that. Like, it just works. It works with a lot of the third-party stuff. I can go in and add things. Let me show you how I would add something. Now, I don't have anything to add. Let's see. Maybe Prism. Let's do Reactor. So, let's say I have Reactor. Just clear everything really quick. Let's say I have Reactor, and let's say you haven't loaded anything for it yet. So, when you first add Reactor, I would go here, click Empty. And then now I would go here and say import a plugin map. And now I would find whatever I want. Let's say I want to do everything. And I would find a plugin map for Reactor. So I can just search it really quick. So Reactor, anything that I have. And I'm going to load, let's do like Polyplex. Pretty sure I have that on here. Or Rounds. Yeah, let's try Rounds. So I load Rounds. I can load multiple ones, Razor, whatever. But let's do Rounds. So we got Rounds. Say okay, I'm gonna import it. And you can see now Rounds is there, and I can actually go through and browse that. So it's really straightforward to add stuff. And then if I want to manually import stuff, I can go here and kind of manually import individual presets. If I click on it, I can do an auto import, which will let me, once you have that on, you can auto import and then go up and down the presets in your plugin, and it will import those as well. So really straightforward in terms of getting your stuff in there. I just wish we can go in and make our own expansions. But overall, man, I'm really impressed with this. I like the build quality. I like how it works and brings all your plugins together. I like the way that you can layer different things like that. I think they did a good job on it. I just hope they continue to improve it and actually stay dedicated to adding more plugin maps and, you know, adding people's suggestions for different plugins that they want to see mapped, and maybe open it up a little bit more when it comes to MIDI mapping, so we can add, you know, multiple pages if we want to do that, different things like that. But overall, man, I think they did a good job on it. Currently, as it is now, I'm going to give it a 4 out of 5 subs. Definitely really well done. I just need them to actually go in and make sure that this transport is working, because I know a lot of people are going to want to actually have that in use. Like, when they see all this in here, you know, when they see all those different maps, they're going to want to be able to use that. So definitely, hopefully, they get that fixed. But other than that, I haven't really had any technical issues. I know some people said they did, but for me, even though I was expecting them, I really didn't have it. Like I said, every once in a while, this browser thing will kind of go black on me, the interface. But again, I chalk that up as to it not being compatible with Windows 10 yet. If that's something you've experienced too, let me know. But for me, it's been really stable, and it's definitely fun to be able to just pull up all your different plugins and not have to worry about loading a bunch of different plugins manually. Just load this and you got all your presets there. So if you have a lot of presets, a lot of different plugins that you like to use together, you want to layer different stuff like that, definitely check it out. It also works well with my external gear, which is important to me. I can quickly just switch it to whatever favorite channel I want to use with my external gear and support it. So you can get this directly from a lot of different places. You can get the information directly from the Akai website. You see all the information there. If you want to learn about the hardware, the models, you want to learn about the software, what software comes with it. A lot of software comes with it. These are the full versions of the plugins. So a lot of stuff there. And then you can get it from different places, like, you know, Z Sounds is $5.99. It's pretty much $5.99 anywhere you're going to go. So really straightforward, nice price. It is built well. I like the feel of it. I like the feel of the keys. I like the feel of it overall. You know, it has a general, definitely plastic, but feels good. The knobs feel good. They don't feel wobbly like they're going to break or anything like that. The pads actually feel really good. I never like pads on a keyboard controller, but these actually do feel really good. So let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Again, this is St. Joe, soundsandgear.com, checking out the Akai Advance 61. 4 out of 5 subs. Let me know what you think. If you have one, let me know what you think about it. If you got any questions, feel free to ask. I'll see y'all later. Peace.